she's getting just great reviews for her moving performance as a teenage runaway in this new film, Welcome to the Rileys. I saw this movie, great low budget. I love low budget movies, and this is a good one. It opens on, what, a Friday, October 29th. Please welcome Kristen Stewart. Good morning. What's different? Okay, oh, the hair, okay. Got the blonde thing going.
Yes.
Yeah, how's that working out, okay?
It worked out, yeah, it looks good.
Did you meet Terry?
Yeah. I thought he was really funny and incredibly, incredibly cute in that last little segment.
Cute.
He was like,
really?
Oh, God, yeah. When he got up and started going, like, when he thought that thing was so funny that he said, he was like, oh, it's like, yes, that was really funny.
Did you know that he played football before the war?
I don't know anything about before the war.
Oh, yeah, in 1938, he was probably probably one of the greatest quarterbacks of all time.
That's amazing.
He got Super Bowl rings before there were Super Bowls.
That's cute.
Do you know he's an actor also?
I've seen him in stuff, totally, yeah.
Really?
He pops up a lot.
Yeah. Well, we have a clip from a film he did. What are you doing? Like this,
eating the fish.
Yeah.
See that? You're naked. In my room.
This is my naked room. I mean, it's my house. And ought to be able to do whatever he wants to do in his own house. Wore a suit for 40 years.
So now we have 40 years of
no suit.
City?
I love it there. Yeah. It's sort of like one city that I feel very much at home in.
Yeah, it's like a crazy place.
It is.
But,
yeah.
But I mean, in a good way. It's just like odd things happen on the street.
You do see some pretty sketch things going down. That's what I really liked about it. That when I was doing this movie,
right.
I played somebody who moved there
right.
and sort of makes it her own, and I sort of got to do the same thing. It was the first time I was alone on a movie.
Okay.
And I really felt like I had to like take my independence in a little city that was like not so easy to do that in.
Yeah.
And I loved it.
Have you ever been there during Mardi Gras or one of those? Like every day is Mardi Gras. It seems like it's Mardi Gras.
Every time there's like a part, like St. Patty's Day. I was there on St. Patty's Day.
Oh yeah. Okay.
It was
any
crazy.
Excuse.
Yeah.
Yeah. Arbor Day. Woo! I mean, any holiday is just an excuse to party. So.
Everyone's birthday.
Now, of course, famous for the seafood. Are you a big seafood person?
Yeah, totally. It's a little, you know, can't really eat the seafood there, I know. I mean, I guess if you're daring, but...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, what did you try something you hadn't had before? What's that thing where you bite the head off? What is that?
I can't do the crawfish because I don't want to suck guts and whatever it is in there.
Right.
Like, essentially, you know what guts are filled with, and I don't
right.
want to be eating that. And,
right. Well, they,
yeah.
you know,
and the way they do that, too, they just, like, knock it off and then... just really grosses me out.
It doesn't sound nearly as appetizing as you say. Yeah. It's, okay, so, now I know you grew up here in Los Angeles.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so like, what do you do for time, when you're here, when you're home, what do you do for time off? What's fun?
I'm really boring, to be honest.
Really?
Yeah. I don't know. I don't do a whole lot. I like to watch movies. It's,
okay. Fun movies.
Yeah. We were talking about the Hollywood Cemetery, and how the movies
yeah, that's
there
a cool
awesome.
Thing, isn't
it's
it?
A cool thing to do, yeah.
At the Hollywood Cemetery here, where it's all the famous people are buried, at least up until the 40s or 50s.
Right.
I don't know so much anymore. But they put screens up at midnight, and they show films in the cemetery.
Yeah, it's a very cool thing to do.
And do you have a favorite headstone that you like to use?
No.
Like, what was the last movie you saw at the cemetery?
Easy Rider? Yeah, it was...
Well, see, that's right, because that was probably the age you are now when that movie came out. What was your impression? Does it seem like just a million years ago? Is it still relevant to someone in your generation when you watch that film? What is it?
Yeah, I really liked it. I mean, it sort of has the... It's nice to watch people, like, be free and independent and, like, you know, do things that people think aren't normal.
Because that, at the time, that was like a revolutionary film. People wrote things about it. This is terrible. It's going to ruin young people. And I look back now, and it seems almost innocent. Is there anything about it seemed like, ooh, outrageous and daring to you?
I mean, I guess the drug thing, but like, other than that, it's just like being sort of knowing the fact that you don't have a direction and knowing that that's your direction and just being like, yeah, that's my direction. Now leave me alone. And that's cool.
Well, the one cool thing about it, that was probably not the first independent film, but the first real counterculture film that just made $1 zillion. And it went, I think it cost like $300,000 to make, and it made $50 million in 1969. Right. Which is pretty amazing. Look, we'll take a break. More with Kristen. We can... Welcome back. Talking with Kristen Stewart. Welcome to the Rileys. It's a new film. Hey, Halloween coming up. Do you celebrate Halloween? Is that like a big deal? Party?
Been working on the last few Halloweens, unfortunately. Yeah, I know, it's a bummer. I know. I used to be obsessed with it when I was a kid.
Really?
My mom's pretty out there, so it was like one of the probably bigger than bigger than Christmas in our house.
So what was your costume? What was your big costume?
You know, it's kind of perfect, embarrassingly perfect. I was at least like 4 years in a row. I was Dracula.
Dracula.
Yeah, with like the widow's peak.
Wow.
Like not a cute Dracula, like a girly Dracula, like a full on.
Wow.
Dracula.
Wow.
Yeah.
It seems to be a theme in your life. Hey, congratulations on this new movie. And I must say, we were talking before. And I love stars like yourself. You do the big commercial movies, the Twilight movies, those are great. Then these little art house movies, because I always believe that money ruins movies. When you have small budgets and no money, people really have to act. And you were terrific. Tell people what the film is about.
It's about a family, like at that time, a disjointed family who's sort of mourning the loss of their daughter. And James Gandolfini goes to New Orleans to just sort of escape that for a second because he's starting to lose it, and meets a girl who's a little reminiscent of his daughter, and they are both equally as broken, and they both sort of see that in each other and help to build up a little bit. And so it's just like a little, it's just a really small sort of like character-driven thing about those people like building their lives up again. But not in a way that's like, you know, their lives don't change completely. It's just now you see that they've affected each other and sort of been like, oh, now I'm going to try a little bit harder and not,
right,
you know.
Right, right. Because when I started watching this film and James Gandolfini, he goes to this strip club and he meets you, and I was going, oh, I don't want to watch a creepy old guy with this. This is going to be creepy.
Right,
and
right.
It takes a different turn. And it was like, oh, I thought, oh, boy, that it really made it interesting. It was not what you think it's going to be.
Right.
Now, you shot this in what, real strip clubs in New Orleans?
Oh, yeah.
And how was that? What lovely places, aren't they?
Oh, yeah.
Do you see that Board of Health A on the wall? Is that
there? Well, they didn't serve food, so I'm not sure. But I love that place.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a real place. It's right off Bourbon Street.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, like, I know the guy who works behind the bar every single day, Felix. Hopefully he's still in the movie. I would love him. He would love that as well. But it was for me, it was pretty skeezy. I mean, I don't know, you know, his establishment's great. But we shot in like the real rooms upstairs,
right.
Like the VIP
rooms.
Room.
Yeah. And so the VIP, that always made me laugh, because you go to these strip clubs and the girl's totally naked, and then they said, you know, in the VIP room there's a private show. I'm like, what is it? Are you gonna take your intestines out? You're naked. Well, I mean, what else am I gonna see that I'm not seeing? I mean, do you go inside out? What could possibly happen up there? That seems rather odd. So, but it's ultimately a very depressing place. And
it can be, totally. I mean, not to be totally depressing, but
no, but
yeah.
Well, I used to work strip clubs when I started. When I was 19, I used to do Liberty Avenue in Pittsburgh and all the strip every because there was a circuit that you did. And
is that what you were into back then?
No, it was a job. That's what I mean. Hey, I'm 19, and there were naked girls at my job. It was fantastic.
Right.
But you know, it was you know what really changed it was drugs. Because when I was a kid, they were like it was still half burlesque, and the girls would be a costume, and it would take like a half hour, and they'd do a whole thing, and be like, woo, 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 and they'd take off.
Right.
Now it seems like drugs, and it seems a lot sleazier.
than it used to be. And that's sort of what your character...
What pushes the girls into doing it.
Right.
That's typically, like, in looking at all of the... I mean, we did research beforehand, me and the director, Jake Scott, and it's so strange how... I mean, it's like a clinical rundown.
Yeah.
Each girl, the story's, like, pretty much the same.
Yeah, it's kind of broken people. But it's, boy, it's a wonderful acting job. What's going to happen in this clip? What's the clip we're going to see? You know what this is?
I've had a really bad night, and I don't want to deal with Jim. I forgot his name, Doug.
Yeah.
And he's gonna tell me a thing or two about how it really is.
Let's take a look. Welcome to the room.
Go to the laundromat. Let's go.
You gonna give me my money today?
Put your clothes on.
Give me my money or get the out of my house.
Here in your birthday suit, displaying your vagina is the only way you could feel in control. Well, you knock yourself out. But I'm tired of your language, especially the word all its various permutations. Now, I know it's your only adjective, but it makes you sound cheap and immature and uneducated. And that may be the truth, but why advertise it? Now, starting today, I'm docking you $1 every time you use that word. So get up, get dressed, get in the shower, brush your teeth. Let's go. Let's go.